India cannot lag behind China and all. Now you have to write where we are lagging or what is the where they are leading us. Since they are leading, we are telling we won't lag. They are leading. Where? Through what? Right? So Chinese initiatives, right in the introduction, the power ambition of China to become a bipolar or to create a G2 condominium, wanting to make two poles in the world today, one US and the other China. But India wanted not bipolarity. India is against unipolarity. India wanted multipolarity. Explain the actions of China, which can be illustrated as examples of the great power ambition of China in Asia and in the Indian Ocean region. OBOR. Write about OBOR. Write about the ambitious project of One Belt One Road Initiative or Belt Road Initiative. What they are trying to do? They are wanting to economically, strategically dominate or influence 60 countries in the world through their OBOR. Then write about CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. How it is threatening or having an impact on the strategic interests of India. Connecting, which one? Kashgar with Gwadar. What is the economic benefit of China? It will cut the distance by 16,000 kilometers. Earlier it has to use India as a transit route when it was using Malacca Strait. Now they can bypass Malacca Strait. India's policy options in the light of they leading. So synoptically you write about where they are leading. 25% of the answer you write, or 20% of the answer you write where they are leading, and thereafter 75% of the weightage you can give to the because in the context I have told, no, the context will have to be also explained. In the context, write about the policy choices. Context will have to be written, no, at least 20%. So briefly you can write about OBOR, CPEC, and then what? String of pearls policy. Then write about how Chinese supremacy is extended in the immediate neighborhood of India by commercial investment or strategic investment, which is only all the above, OBOR or CPEC or string of pearls. So this is the context. 20% you write. Then write, given the situation, what are the choices present, options present. You have some options like international north-south transport corridor, a 7,200 kilometer corridor. What benefit you will get? It's a counter to Belt Road Initiative. It can get you connected to Central Asia, Russia, and even Europe. The second option should be Chabahar port modernization. The third option is Sagarmala project, direct or indirect development of the cities through ports. Fourth, you write about Project Mosam. Fifth, you write about Indian Ocean Rim Association, where China is not there. Indian Ocean Naval Symposium, you write. Then you can also write about how commercial investment of China is only leading to protest, whereas the developmental assistance of India is winning so much of support. So India has a soft power. Then write about BIMSTEC. So these are the options, policy options you have.
Asia Africa growth
corridor. Exactly, with the help of Japan. Asia Africa. See, no infrastructural project is region specific, first of all, because the infrastructure will spur growth beyond the immediate neighborhood. First of all, if you have time, you write. Otherwise, it is better when you talk about the geographical space, then you cannot bring the India-Africa growth corridor. It may be indirectly helping you. It may be indirectly helping you, because where you can say, if these are wealth of G4 countries, you can ask for UN Security Council seat. Because there should be one seat given to Africa or not. Best is what? International North-South Corridor, Sagarmala, Project Mosam, IORA, Indian Ocean Naval Symposium, BIMSTEC can be also written. Chabahar Port modernization can be written. And the soft power status of India in the neighborhood. Most importantly, when China disrespected the international court's verdict on South China Sea, India accepted the international court's verdict on Bay of Bengal dispute with Bangladesh. Credibility of India, support of India to the international arbitration institutions or dispute settlement institution is having more takers today. It was lauded today. This is what is a soft power which you have to use, leverage, to win over China. Otherwise, it is difficult. They are $8 trillion, $9 trillion economy, you are $2 trillion economy. By 2030, you wanted to become how much? 10? 10 no. They are having their yuan in SDR basket. 25 countries are there, they are accepting yuan and all. You can't match them. So, have the power of soft power status is good. Indians will win Oscars. Indians will be present as international authors. India will provide humanitarian assistance. More than 50% of the humanitarian assistance or 50% of the military operation of UN, India participated. Even though we did not support directly the Rohingyas, we supported Bangladesh government through Operation Insaniyat. Idellame soft role of India. These are soft roles of India, soft power status of India.